After discussing the supervised learning classification and regression, now we are at the moment to discuss generalization of the model. Remember that in machine learning, we provide the train set, and in that train set, we have the features and the target value, the correct true labels. Then we expect that the model trains itself and learns from it. After we have the train model, we will take this model to implement, to deploy in an environment that it will decide for the given but unseen samples from the real life, and it will try to predict. But how much it could be successful in testing or in real life compared to the success in training? So I would like to explain this concept before getting into the generalization. I will just talk about two different things right now, train and test. Let me put here the train, and here is the test. In train time, what we provided, remember what we have done? We were, let's say that a black box of machine learning algorithm we are gonna learn later. And this is the machine learning algorithm that we are gonna teach. So let me put machine learning, any machine learning, supervised machine learning algorithm. Then remember that we provide a input set. These are all the features. Let me put the F here. The features. We provide all these features. And remember that we have also the output, the correct true label. These are the true labels or target feature. Okay. And we also provide these to the machine learning algorithm. And remember that these together, these and these together called train set. Okay. In training, we provide the each sample, for example, the sample feature values. And these feature values, we provide the correct output expected. So machine learning method will use these inputs and the correct output such that it will just understand the relationship between all these data sets and creates a function. So we can write the machine learning algorithm like that. F X, capital X, returns Y in mathematical sense. So in mathematical sense, that's the X, that's the Y. So far we have no problem. What I am saying that we provide the train set in a supervised method, either regression or classification. Okay, we have already just run and assumed that the function F somehow learns how to convert, transform from X to Y. Learn. And assume that we have the accuracy metric and say that we have 95% accuracy in doing this on train set. But if we have the test set, and what is the test set? Let me explain. In the test set, actually, we have most of the time, we have features again. Okay. And what we do, we just get the model, train model, and use the train model. Now, this is not just a model right now. It is the train model. Okay, this is the train model. Train model means that we already train in the train phase. Okay, so this is train machine learning model. All right. Now, what we are gonna do, this is the features again. This is the true labels or the target feature, the same. But this time there is something different. We provide, okay, the features only. Okay. So the this three model provides us the output. Remember from here. So when we provide the f x, this is x, the features, it will provide us the output, the prediction. So these are the predictions. It could be classification or regression, but just the prediction. Here we have the true labels. So what can we do now with this y? So we can compare the output of the train model y and compare with the result. So in the comparison, we can check that if y is equal to or similar to, with some respect, similar to the true label. So we provide the feature of the sample as a x. That train model, for example, says it's setosa. We look if it is setosa or not. So we provide the second one as an x. The train model provides the y, and we compare that y value with this, for example, Virginica. And we just know how many training samples and number, and we can find the accuracy in that case, right? How many correctly predicted total prediction. So it gives us a accuracy. But I will come to these points later. Do you understand the difference between the train and test? In train, we provide the features and the true labels at the same time. Machine learning tries to find, don't forget, it's really important. Actually, machine learning algorithm tries to find this F function. Okay, this F function in train. That's the goal. But in test, we use this F function already we have to answer the question, what is that X? You are gonna say is a Y setosa. What is that X? It is Virginica. What is that S? Blah blah. So according to your answer, the answer Y, I am going to compare with the real value. Then I will calculate a accuracy metric. All right. Any questions? Do you understand the difference between the train and test phases? Okay, that's really important. But pay attention then. This is the train set. Okay, this is the train set. This is called with this and this test set. The train set and the test sets are two different sets. The samples are totally different. Therefore, we see that the machine learning model learns from the train set, but we test the train model with test set. In the test set, the train model never seen before these samples. It is really important. So we would like to have the success in train. We can calculate the success here. I will give the details, and you can calculate the success here. Tell me which success is important, at the train time or at the test time? Which success is important for you?
Test time.
Test time or train time?
Test time.
One says test time.
Train time, sir.
Both are important, sir.
Both of them, train time. What about the others? Anil, Erdoğan.
I think test time.
Test time, okay. Ege, train, test. Ege, train. Berke, Gülsün, train. Berke, test. Okay, actually both of them. Because our idea is to create a model that we are gonna use in our real life, right? So in real life means that almost test time, right? Because we are testing the model with unseen examples. At the deployment after test, we expect that if the distribution of data is correctly sampled from the real life, then we expect that the test accuracy will be similar to the real life. Okay, but let me put here, this is important because after everything is finished, we deploy the model into, this is the model. Now we deploy into the real life. Real life. Assume that you work in Facebook. Now you develop something, you train it, you test it, then you deploy onto the Facebook web service. Now the users can see their best closest friends. So how many friends are actually the closest friends that we predict? So this is the deploy time, actually accuracy. But we hope that this accuracy will be similar to the test time. Because in test time, the model predicts on or using unseen examples. But in train type, if you think that, we will not train once our system. We will train using the same data, train set. We will run multiple times. And during the each trains, we call epoch. In each epoch, the machine learning model will learn new things until saturate to some point of accuracy. After that, we will take this model to use in a test environment. If test and train accuracies are good, I will explain in a moment, then we can use it in real life and expect that it will have similar accuracy in real life. Now, I have several questions. Please pay attention. Do you have any questions so far?
No, Professor, everything is clear.
Okay. Now, assume that in the train time, just assume that in the train time, we have 100% accuracy, but in test time, we have 70% accuracy. Is there any problem for you? Anyone?
Yes, sir.
What is the problem?
Sir, it's not predicting with that accuracy. I mean, it should be.
No, what is the problem here? Problem.
Problem.
Yes, what is the problem? In test time, we have 100%. It knows everything. But in test, it is missing 30% of the questions.
Okay, sir, I think we need more data. Or more training.
No, what is the problem? I am not asking the remedy. I am asking the problem about the accuracies. What's the problem in that accuracies? The accuracies. What's the problem in that accuracy? Everybody sees that. In training, it is too high. In test, it is very low. Is that right? So simple, huh? Okay. Now, it is too high in training. But comparison with that, it's very low in test. Why? Assume that you are gonna take a test, okay, in mathematics class, for example. And in mathematics class, your teacher distributed some homeworks, okay? And with the solutions. So you get these homeworks with solutions, you memorize all of them. You memorize all the homeworks with the solutions. When you test, when you apply these homeworks, what you would get if you only apply these homeworks as an exam? What you are gonna get as a grade?
Maybe if the question is out of those questions.
No, I am asking, listen to my question. I am saying that you memorize the homeworks with solutions and you in the exam, these questions given to you, what would be your grade?
It will be very good.
100, because you memorize it.
Yes.
Okay. But after memorizing these questions with solutions, if in the exam, teacher asks you different questions, what yeah. would be probably?
Yeah, it grade? Will be not good.
There is not good, right?
Yes.
Because you have now questions unseen during your study, right? Yes. So you can think that the train is study for the exam with some homeworks. You can think the test, the exam with unseen questions. Is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Ege Osman, is it clear? Ezgi? Okay. That's the point. You can think that as a student, you can think that this is the study time with some solutions here and assume that that's the exam time as a student, okay? As a student. So in that case, you think that the student memorized the questions, but in the exam, there are the unseen questions asked, so you get a lower grade. Do you understand now? So I am asking again, for the train and test case, for the accuracies, for the real life deployment, what would you like to have as a success rate, as an accuracy in train and test?
When we predict untrained and trained, both of them together, we can increase our test level result. Okay. We should predict both of them, untrained and trained together.
Train and test. No, it's not a good idea.
It's not
a
good idea.
Yes, it's not a good idea. Adam, it looks like that teacher gives you all the questions to you, then you memorize all of them, then in the test, some of the questions appears again.
But if we want to have a very good high score testing,
then it's a cheat. Right? What happens in the deployment than in real life? Tell me. Şöyle. If you have the unseen questions in real life, assume that you graduate from school and then you begin a job, what happens then? If in the job there are unseen questions, you fail.
We should predict and...
But you cannot predict because you only learn a small amount of things. You cannot learn everything because this is the data set you collect from real life. You cannot collect all the setosas, all the iris flowers. You cannot do this. You cannot collect all the houses. They are just samples.
Yes, exactly. But here, this 13% fault is for unpredict, untrained problems. It's because of untrained problems.
Yes. There is no untrained problems. We are using the terminology train and test. That's all. Train and test. Train set and test set. Please use this terminology. I don't understand you otherwise.
Yes. Okay, I got it.
Okay. So basically, it means that at this position, the train, the model memorize but does not learn. Do you understand the difference between memorize but not learn? Do you understand the difference between this? Memorize, but doesn't. So in this example, it memorized the examples here, but when we test with the unseen data, it is failing. So actually, as I said, that in real life, assume that in Ankara, there are 1 million houses, for example, but you only collected 10K of them. So using this 10K of them, maybe you split this 8K for train and 2K for test. Okay. And you train on your test model, then you deploy this model in real life to predict 1 million hours. So it's not easy. Just using 10K of samples out of 1 million samples and create a model that will work with 1 million unseen. You understand? Or you prepare a model to predict the cancer and you only collected 2,000 patients' data. Then you try to predict everyone in the world if he or she is cancer or not. So it's not easy to do this because you only sample from real life and the sample data is very, very low ratio compared with the real data. Now, our aim is to that in the train, we get a higher accuracy. In the test, we also have a higher accuracy, hoping that in real life, we have the higher accuracy as well in the deployment, in the real life. But remember that in the real life, there are millions of data that we have never trained or test. So we expect that the model trainees here well and the trained model performs well in test, hoping that it will learn, not memorize, in training. And what it learns in training, it can generalize to the real life. So that is the topic about generalization. Okay. In generalization means that you learn, the model learns something, the F function, remember here, the F function, so that transform the X to Y, and we hope that in the test, this F function behaves good, and then we hope that this F function works in real life. Because the F function is created by the model automatically according to the trained data. According to the trained data. But trained data is a very, very small part of the real data. Okay, now is that clear? So we would like to, our function is general one, not specific one. I will explain in a moment. Any questions so far? Go over that again. If a model is able to make accurate predictions on unseen data, it means the test data or the deployment data, we say it is able to generalize from training set to the test set. We want to build a model that's able to generalize as accurately as possible. So we don't like only successful models, only on trained data. We would like to have a model successful at train time and test time.